Yes, I know the game has been out for like 4 years now, and I know that this video is only going to be applicable to the minority. But I wanted to make this video because with the news that came out last week that GTA Online had the most amount of players ever in the last 2 months, I wanted to make a video talking about how to get started as a new player and sort of what to do with your money, how to spend it, what you should spend it on to get to like the top the quickest, I guess you could say. To get like the big name items like the bunker, the MOC, the oppressor, all these pretty big items, these pretty expensive items, you know, how you can get those in the most efficient manner. So hopefully in this video, this helps you out if you are a new player getting started or just getting back into GTA Online. You don't need to be a level 1 player. You could be a level 120 freaking player, but not have, you know, any money and maybe you haven't played GTA for a few years, but you've seen all this amazing stuff in the trailers and all that, and you want to get back into it because it looks freaking awesome. So what I'm going to do in this video is show you guys a step-by-step guide, and it's super simple. This isn't like some crazy elaborate plan. It's basically just a pretty simple guideline on how to start and how to finish and how to spend your money in the best possible way. And I also think, you know, this is subjective, but in my opinion, this is the most fun way to make money and to grind GTA, if you want to call it that. There are some other methods, but those I'm not going to touch on because I personally don't like those and I think most people wouldn't. So the first thing that I want to talk to you guys about is becoming a VIP. Now they actually, Rockstar actually changed it a few updates, or maybe it was the last update, where you only have to have $50,000 in your bank account to become a VIP. And getting $50,000 is really simple to do. You can do like 3 contact missions and you have $50,000, or you can sell some cars, you have $50,000. So that's not like the hardest thing in the world to get done. Once you have $50,000, so that's where this is, that's where this entire plan is going to start, because then you can become a VIP and you can do VIP missions. And in my opinion, VIP missions are probably the second most fun thing to do in GTA Online because there is somewhat of a variety of them, and I feel like they are fairly simple to do as well. So once you become a VIP, that's in your interaction menu, by the way, if you're like completely new. The ones we're going to go ahead and do are called Sightseer, Headhunter, and I believe Hostile Takeover. I'm not going to go in depth on how you should play these missions or the ways that you can stagger these missions to basically do them back to back to back. I will see if I can find a link to the videos I've done in the past on that certain topic, and I'll leave a link in the description. But once you go ahead and do the VIP mission, this is going to give you roughly between like 16,000 to 23 or 24,000 each time you do it, depending on how quick you actually do it. So maybe you want to take a little bit longer because you might get a bigger payout. Just some minor tips regarding these. If you're just starting off, check the car websites, because I know the Duke of Death for some people is actually free. And that is a fantastic car to do these VIP missions in, because you can shoot out of it, but it's bulletproof to an extent. So the NPCs are going to have a really hard time killing you, and that's going to be a lifesaver, because it's a pain when you do these missions with regular vehicles. The NPCs have god accuracy and they just shoot you every single time through the window. So this one, it makes it really easy. So I would recommend, you know, checking the vehicle websites and seeing if you have the free Duke of Death. If not, then you may have to work towards it or the armored Kuruma. And these missions may be a little more difficult just because you're gonna have to go on foot probably and take out the guys without having an armored vehicle, but that's still not too bad. The NPCs aren't too hard. And what you're gonna wanna do though with these VIP missions is you're gonna wanna grind them until you can afford a high-end apartment. And the lowest, the cheapest high-end apartment is actually only $2,000. And it's actually right next to the cheapest office building, which I'll touch on in a second. So that may be something you want to look into. But another one that's really great is the $217,000 option for the high-end apartment, because it's in the middle of the city. It's in a, you know, it's a central location. So that might be another option you want to choose. Really, I would say at this time, the apartment location does not matter. Back in the day, it used to, but now it's kind of irrelevant. It's the only reason you would ever go to your apartment is for heists and then maybe the 10-car garage that comes with it. So just buy the cheapest one and that'll work just as good as the most expensive one. And it being only $200,000, that's only going to take a few VIP missions. You might even be able to get that like within an hour, so it's something that is easily accomplishable. Now once you own that high-end apartment, what you can do is play heists. And if you are somewhat of a new player, heists are actually really fun. Now, after you play them multiple times and you grind them over and over again, they become kind of boring. But if you're just starting off, whatever, if you've maybe only even played them once or twice, they're still pretty fun to do with your friends. Now, when it comes to heists, you're going to want to do them all in order because you get a bonus for doing that. You also get a bonus for playing on hard, and you also get a bonus if you complete every single mission in the heists with the same four people. And all of that, all those little challenges add up. You know, they give you like 1 million, 2 million, I think maybe even $3 million extra dollars in addition to the stuff you're getting from the heist. So you might want to look up those heist challenges. Obviously, the big one, the criminal mastermind, is to complete all of them on hard without dying. That may be difficult, but that gives you $10 million. So that's a huge chunk of change if you want to get into it right off the bat. But that's going to be a little difficult just because, you know, it's on hard and it's GTA, things happen. So you might not want to try that right off the bat, but that is an option. But yeah, the heists, this, I'm not going to show you guys any gameplay because I've done them multiple times and it's hard for me to get people in the lobbies just because people always join and then they leave. So really, if you're doing this, don't really play with randoms. I would just suggest there's websites, there's places out there. Look up heist friends or heist, looking for heist people or something in Google, and I'm sure you'll find it. The only thing you should know when you're hosting heist is make sure to always have it set to player saved outfits, because there are actually some vests that you can wear from free mode that give you a little bit of a health increase in heist. You just can't sprint. That may sound a little complicated, but as a new player, I really wouldn't worry too much about it. But yeah, do heist, and then you're gonna use that money to purchase an office. And this is probably easily done within a day. I would say you can do all five of the heists within maybe like 2-3 hours, depending on how fast and how, you know, competent your teammates are. But the reason we're using our heist money to purchase an office is because that is where the real moneymaker is going to come from. And the cheapest office, like I was saying earlier, is $1 million. So that's easily gettable from the heists. The heists, I don't know exactly how much they pay out, because it is, you can change the payout. But in the end, you definitely make at least $1 million, if not way more. So being able to purchase that $1 million office is definitely attainable by just playing heist. Now, there are some other ones. The one I have is a really good one. It's the Arcadius building. I think it's like $3 million. So maybe if you want to splurge, you could save up some more. It's just going to take more grinding. But for the sake of just making money, you don't need the $3 million one. It's only, you know, a little bit of a benefit because it's in a different location. But if you get the cheapest office and the cheapest high-end apartment, they will be right next to each other, so that's something to keep in mind as well. Now, once you buy an office, this is, like I said, where the real moneymaker is going to happen. So, by now, you might not have a whole lot of money since you just spent it on the office, but you're going to want to work up to, I think it's $1.5 million. And the reason you're going to want that amount is because you're going to want to buy a vehicle warehouse. If you go to the office chair and you go to the office computer, you can see, if you go to vehicle cargo, you can see all of the vehicle warehouses around the map. There's not too many of them, and some of them are really expensive. Some of them are like $3 million, but the cheapest two, I think one's $1.6 million, and then the one I own, I can't see the price, but I believe it was like $1.5 or $1.4 million. And the way you can get that amount of money is either by, I guess, replaying heists or by doing the VIP missions again. Now, I do want to sort of quickly take a little sidestep here and say that this isn't like the 100% definitive guide to GTA Online. You can do whatever you want. You know what I mean? Like, if you want to follow my guide loosely, go for it. You know, if you want to branch off and do some racing, or if you want to branch off and do some free mode events or help with some bodyguard stuff, you know, or do some contact missions, go for it. Do whatever you find fun. But I'm just telling you guys that this sort of guide is one of the best, in my opinion, to go off of, or to loosely base your playing time off of, to get what you want faster. Now, going back to the guide. So once you either grind heists or grind VIP missions or do contact missions to get the amount of money you need to buy a vehicle warehouse, that is where this is really going to start taking off. Because once you own a vehicle warehouse, then you can source cars from your CEO office. And all of this is free. That's the best part about the import-export missions. So once you source these vehicles, you just bring them back to your vehicle warehouse and then you can sell them. Now you're only going to want to sell the top range cars because those give the most money. The other ones are kind of pointless, but each top range car sells for $100,000, although you only actually end up getting like $80,000 because there's a $20,000 pay something that you have to do. It's really stupid, but basically you're getting $80,000 for each car, and you can actually have other people in your group if you want to sell more than one, but it's really easy to do solo. And this, every $80,000, that's going to start adding up. And then over time, this is what you're going to do to get the bunkers or to get the new vehicles that come out. To sort of wrap this up, I would say that honestly, getting the vehicle warehouse and getting started with the import-export stuff is not that hard to do. It might take you a weekend to get all of that done because you really only need like $3 or $4 million total to get all of that stuff completed. I mean, you need $200,000 for the high-end apartment, $1 million for the cheapest office, so that's only $1.2 million, and then $1.5 million for a vehicle warehouse. That's not even $3 million, and we basically can get started with making money. Now, I do want to point out, it's a game that pretty much is about grinding, so from here on out, you know, after you get that, then it's going to be somewhat of a grind to get the amount of money you need for maybe if you want to buy a yacht or a bunker or a MOC or an oppressor, you know, any of these other new things. It is going to be a bit of a grind, but with the import-export, I find it to be really fun and somewhat challenging, so it's not too bad. So there you guys have it. That is the guide on how to get started as a new player in GTA Online. The only other thing I will say is that at any point, if you have an extra $1.7 million, buy a Buzzard. A Buzzard is super useful, especially for the VIP missions, really for any of the missions, because you can use them in contact missions, you know, the free mode events, whatever, just getting around easier. As a CEO, you can actually spawn a Buzzard for free right next to you if you own a Buzzard without paying for it. So having a Buzzard's really nice to have, but it is $1.7 million. There are some times when Rockstar put it on sale, but that doesn't happen too often. So maybe, you know, after you get your office or after you do the heist, you want to save for a Buzzard so you can grind VIP missions easier or something like that. Just an idea I wanted to let you guys know about. But yeah, I will leave a link or a few links in the description to some other guides and tips on if you want to know more, I guess, on how to get started and how to do better with your money and all that in GTA Online. But this is it. Hopefully this helped. I tried to sort of simplify it as much as I possibly can. And I'm hoping, you know, this helps a few people out there that are maybe getting back in to GTA Online. So thank you all. That is it. As always, though, I'll see you guys in the next one.